Hey everyone, Robert Mugabe's leadership is something that news organisations seem to refer to as, quote, controversial, which is of course a polite way of saying that you trust him to manage your economy the way that you trust Harold Shipman to manage your end-of-life care. It's like if the newspapers had described the Cray twins as cheeky chappies, or the BBC were mourning that the ISIS leadership seemed, quote, set in their ways. Anyway, Mugabe's been in charge of Zimbabwe for decades now, pushing forward with his own form of nationalism, which is a self-described version of Marxist-Leninist African socialism. Skip to the end a bit, and it roughly translates, unsurprisingly, into money for no one, murder and famine for everyone. Yay, socialism. Perhaps that's somewhat harsh. I will admit that he does seem to spread to poverty and misery in a very egalitarian manner. In the 1980s, Mugabe led the transition of power away from Ian Smith's apartheid regime. Then once he was in control, he managed to run the place a bit like how David Moyes ran Manchester United. Things finally came to head though this week with a coup led by the Zimbabwean military. It largely comes down to the classic secession problem of who becomes a dictator after the current dictator dies. It's why the Roman emperors ended up spending the 3rd century managing to murder everyone with a pace akin to a bad soap opera. Robert Mugabe is revered by many, though, surprisingly, essentially because he's 93 years old and it's a culture where older gentlemen are very much held in respect. His wife, however, that's a different story. She's more of a Hillary Clinton figure, except with more corruption and embezzlement, and essentially, as I said, she's more of a Hillary Clinton figure. And the military want to make sure that eventually there's a return to proper elections and normal government. So now we have the bizarre situation where Mugabe is in power but not in charge. He's essentially a constitutional monarch, like Queen Elizabeth, who he hates. Ain't irony a glorious thing, eh, people? Anyway, see you next week. If you like these, click subscribe.